What is going on, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, women and children of all ages? This is HydroxideAnt here with you, playing some Tales from the Borderlands. Why talk about all that? I don't know, let's just jump right in. Start from episode one? Yeah, why not? Seems like a nice place to start. Episode 1 instead of starting at like episode 9. I don't even know how many episodes there are. This game series adapts to the choices you make. The story is tailored by how you play.
Back again to hear another story of immense fortune and unthinkable peril. Well, I have some time. The Borderlands of Pandora. We're told to contain mysterious alien treasure troves filled with advanced technology and incredible power. Vaults, the people called them. And to seek one out was to earn you the title of Vault Hunter. At least by me. You could say Handsome Jack was one such explorer, though his methods could be seen as somewhat unsporting. He ran the corporation Hyperion and died trying to claim Pandora as his own. History's attention is fickle, my friends. It will remember those pirates like Handsome Jack, but forget the adventurers who risk it all for less, obvious rewards. Stories. Legends. Those are much better at getting at the real spirit of things. Stories remember both sides of the tale.
Where the hell are we? That looks ferocious.
Fiona! Come on, we can work this out!
Fiona? What, is there some sort of radiation leak I don't know about?
Well then, that's no bueno. We're kind of taped up and can't really do anything.
So, who are you?
I ask the questions.
Okay, then, do you mind asking yourself who you are?
Oh! Ow, what the hell?
Tell me about the Gordas Project.
Is that what this is about? Look. Gordas is bad business. If you want a real hot investment, I am on the ground floor of some property on feed. Okay.
Don't be a smartass.
No, don't shoot there, man.
I'm not a patient person. So just start talking.
Just where do you start when you're getting dragged through the desert and,
from the beginning.
Right.
Ooh.
I guess it all started with a promotion. See, I'd spent my entire career up at Hyperion, so I suppose that makes me one of the bad guys in this story. And Handsome Jack, he was the baddest guy of them all.
This long. It must feel good
to
finally grab it,
just like him.
Take it. It's yours, right? I mean, you always said that.
Everyone did.
I gotta be honest, I always thought it was sort of cheesy, but hey, here
Which
we are.
Which resulted in a company overflowing with assholes.
Animals.
When Handsome Jack died, it somehow got even worse. It took some time to fit in. But a few stabs and select backs, a new haircut, and the help of a couple friends, I was on my way to get the promotion that was going to change my life. Scratch that. Our lives. For the better. I was a little distracted. It was a big day for us. Luckily, Vaughn was concentrating on the important things.
What's the first thing you're going to buy? I know what Henderson's making. I do his payroll.
The money man.
If you're getting a fraction of what he earns, you'll be rolling in it. Being an exec in Hyperion comes with expectations.
Yeah, I figure I could get lunch. Seems like a good place to start.
Well, then we're starting with three of whatever's most expensive.
Sure.
And wine pairings.
For lunch?
We're gonna get twisted, bro.
We're gonna get twisted, bro! If
we now call this afternoon, then we are doing it wrong. We're meeting with a vet afterward to celebrate. She booked us a table.
Yep. Sounds good.
Look, we had to do a lot of awful stuff to get you to this point. Do I regret some of it? Sure I do. Every night it haunts my dreams, but that doesn't matter now. Because you made it. You deserve this, man. And don't ever think you don't. And don't ever think about the Iridium mine deal we put together.
Thanks for the help, Vaughn. Really. I couldn't have done this without you and Yvette.
Hey, man, don't sweat it. I'm just happy we even got you here. You know, I crunched the numbers one night and figured out there was a 45% chance someone would kill you before this day.
Glad that didn't happen.
Me too.
Yeah.
It was real touch and go there for a
minute. Same.
All right, man. Let's get that Hyperion face on.
Oh, right, yeah.
No, we need some condescending. It's a little too friendly right now. Okay, tell you what. Tilt your head back. Like if you ask me if there's anything up your nose.
How's that?
There you go. You don't respect me at all. Perfect.
Mr. Henderson?
Have a seat, Reese. I'll just be a second. No, I wasn't talking to you. Yes, I'm talking to you now.
Yeah, but I don't want it in red. I want it in black. Because black is better. Look, don't concern yourself with why, okay, Jerry?
Is that
concern
crunk?
Yourself with how.
With the episode.
And just send
Emperor's
the car over
crew.
When it's ready. Company car. Didn't even have to ask. You look surprised to see me, Reese. And if I'm reading the situation right, and I usually am, you're not too happy about it either. This all came together quick. So, you might not have been in the loop.
So where's Henderson?
He, stepped out. You're going to be reporting to me now, Reese. And I want you to know the promotion that you worked so hard to get, that's still coming to you.
Well, that's a relief.
But this is about more than that, Reese. It's about your future in this company. Look, you want to know the reason why I'm in that chair and you're not? For the exact same reason why North is North, why the handsome guy always gets the girl, and why every spaceship in the universe is shaped like a cock. It's destiny, Reese. And men, real men, men like me, make their own. And you could hold a grudge if you like. No harm, no foul, your thoughts are your own. But bad things can happen when you swim against fate. Sometimes men find themselves standing in the
way. Is that Henderson in the background?
Destiny. You don't want to be that man. Wow. I could not have timed that better. That really helps dramatically make my point. Which is this. This promotion is going to take you out of the way of other people's destiny. And put you on your own path. And that, my friend, is why I am promoting you to... Jerry, why isn't my new car digistructing in my office yet?
Vasquez, it's August.
Oh, August. Cool, listen. I actually have somebody here with me, so...
Are you buying this vault key or what? Because I... How did this happen so quick? I thought I'd have more time. Of course I'm still interested. Yes, I'm near a computer. 10 million. Yeah. It's just that's a lot of money to get together on short notice. I mean, I'm not trying to be obstinate, but I need time.
Three years sucking up to the guy. Out the window.
No, but... Do you want the money or not? It's not. No, it won't be a big deal for me to get... Yes. Why are you trying to screw me on this? Oh, fuck. Just wait there, okay?
Oh, it's important.
I can only be down it. If it's gonna be $10 million, I'm gonna need another hour or two. Okay. Yeah, I'll be there in a bit. Well, then just stay there. It's a tourist shop, right? Buy a mug or something. Sure. Okay, say hi to your mom. Damn it! Ah, right. What were we talking about? Before we were so rudely interrupted.
We were talking about my promotion.
All right, your promotion. Anderson was a fool. He didn't know his place. He needed lesson number one. Humility.
But you, I respect you, Reese. That's why I'm gonna make you assistant vice janitor.
What? No. No, you can't.
I'm the boss now, Reese. I do whatever I want. Report to Sewage Scout 23. Effective immediately.
You better get an eye installed in the back of your head. Because you never know when I could be creeping up behind you.
I'm your boss, Reese. Get used to that. This is what I'm talking about when I say humility. That was lesson number two. Don't make lesson number three about a number two.
What?
Don't make me crap on the floor and make you clean it up. You're dismissed, Reese. I'll let you know when I need my trash can emptied.
What the hell was that? He can't do this to us.
He just did.
No. No, this can't be happening.
I'm finished, Bob. I'm finished. You know how this place is.
There's blood in the water, and everyone can smell it. No, they can't. Not yet, unless you don't quiet down. We just gotta keep it on the down low until we figure something out. It's not...
Senior Vice Janitor Reese to Sector D451 for trash cleanup. Because that is your job now, to clean up trash with your bare hands.
Sorry, you were saying something. I interrupted you.
Reese, why are you cleaning up trash? I thought you were getting a promotion. Trash duty seems like the opposite of a promotion.
Henderson's dead.
What? Are you sure?
Yeah. I mean, you can ask him yourself. He's floating outside in space!
It's that prick Vasquez. He threw Henderson out of an airlock and demoted Reese to trash man.
Holy crap. So, does that mean you're not buying?
Ha 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 ha! Screw this.
Well, just trying to lighten the mood. And I didn't bring my wallet, so if someone pays for me...
I'll tell you who's gonna pay. Vasquez.
I don't know if he's the type
to... We can't let that prick get away with this. We need to do something.
He just killed a guy. Maybe it's better we lay low for a bit.
What? No way. We hit back.
We're gonna ruin his career.
How do you plan on doing that?
Yeah. Vasquez set up a deal on Pandora for a vault key.
Whoa. A vault key?
Uh-huh. And I'm sure he promised a die period.
That must be why he got the promotion. The only thing Hyperion cares about more than money is vault keys. It's perfect! I mean, not only do we screw over Vasquez, we have a friggin' vault key! What are they worth? Like $1 billion?
More.
Yeah, but we need $10 million right now to make the deal.
Hold, please. Done.
I'm not gonna lie. That was impressive.
I'm in accounting. I mean, it's what I do. $10 million is chump change around here. By the time anyone notices, we'll have a vault key.
Cool. Well, looks like you boys got it all figured out. I'm gonna go eat. Alone. Call me if you don't get killed,
Whoa, hey, we need your help. We need clearance, transportation. You're a requisitions master. We need that stuff.
Yeah, maybe a loader bot or two. You know, things get dicey.
Look, it's one thing stealing from a bunch of poor suckers on Pandora. You're talking about stealing from Hyperion.
But we're friends. Friends help each other steal stuff. I mean, that's how it works.
Richter used to steal candy bars. His family still doesn't know where the body is.
Come on, Yvette. We're in this together. One of us moves up, we all move up.
Yeah, and by that same logic, in some way, we all just got demoted to janitor. Do you really want that?
Vasquez really screwed us, didn't he? Fine. But I'm still hungry.
No problem. We only got a couple hours.
Go withdraw the cash. I'll get you guys clearance to Pandora, get you geared up, and issue you a standard Hyperion town car.
What? Standard? Really? I mean, you can't spring for premium? Seat warmers, maybe a convertible or something?
Sure, yeah, a convertible. So, just so I got this straight, you want me to get you a car to drive around Pandora that leaves you less protected, right?
Look, it just... You're gonna steal something, I figure...
No. No, don't worry. I've got a car in mind.
Oh no, he's not gonna do it, is he? Is he gonna take the boss's car? I think he's gonna do it. He lived long. Ooh, it's a sick. He drives sick. Mark would be impressed. Oh, it's Tokyo Drift, boys and girls. It's a pretty sign.
Person.
Where would you cross right there?
Oh, crap. I think we killed it. Are we murderers now?
We're murderers. We're murderers. Great, we murder.
Well, at least it didn't suffer.
Yeah, I guess. Sucks, though.
Yeah. Sucks.
It's not dead. It was moving. Oh, no.
So, what do we say if someone asks where we got the money?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, what do we tell people? We should have a story. I would prefer not to tell them that we stole it from Hyperion. That would not go over well. I just think we need a plan of some sort.
Let's just say Vasquez gave it to us to make the deal. It's easier that way.
Yeah. I guess I wanted a cooler plan, but I suppose that'll work.
So, this looks not good.
Got ourselves a clue here. What are you looking at?
It's Pandora. What did you expect?
Yeah, no, I know. I guess I'm just now more acutely aware that I have $10 million chained to me is all.
In a neighborhood, I might add, of backplanet nut jobs. I'm just getting a vibe, you know?
What the hell are you afraid of, huh? It's just a town like any other with a little more dust.
What am I afraid of? Oh, I don't know, old mining community stranded on a planet, getting prospector madness and eating us for one.
Listen, one tap on the arm and Yvette can send down a loader bot if things get too entertaining.
That's true.
And she gave me this. It is a stun baton. I do not know how it works, but it's definitely neat.
Yeah, stick. Neato. God, I can't wait to be in that chair. You and me, Yvette. I mean, we bring this key back, and they're gonna make us the once and future kings of that place for sure. They'll send in a crew to use the key, and then that's it. Then it's kick back on the moon beach time.
Yeah, yeah. We'll pop champagne and everything after we get back with the key.
Ah, come on. It's in the bag. The tracker's beep, beep, beeping, but I don't see the place.
It's the World of Curiosities, right?
Yeah, do you see it?
No.
Could ask one of them. They seem normal-ish. Normal-ish enough, anyway.
What an excellent idea.
I thought so myself.
Oh, God.
Hi. Excuse me. Sir, do you know where the World of Curiosities is?
It should be around here.
You lost? What are you here for?
It's just a simple business deal. A few papers to sign, and then we're out. Easy.
Huh. Those the papers?
Of a sort?
You're Hyperion. Earwake suckers ruined this town, you know that? Atlas were bastards, but at least they had the good sense to fail. When Jack came in, he turned everything to smoke.
Okay. What's it gonna take, huh? How much? 20? 50?
It'd take a lot more than that. Hey, little man. What's in the case? Hey, kitty cat. Show us what's in the case.
Okay, now, look, before we get all bent...
Is there, like, a convention or something?
Oh. Bandits.
You know what we got here?
Reese, do the...
We got a couple Hyperion warmongers, gentlemen.
The bot! Yvette, prime it!
Already? Really?
Just... give me the menu.
Okay, but don't go bananas. These things ain't cheap.
And do you know what we do with warmongers? Do you know what we do? Should we tell them what we do with Hyperion workers?
Who is that?
Reese, come on, just get it.
Motorbot deployed.
Time to clock in.
Yee-haw!
Listen, boys. You're gonna hand over that case, or you're handing over your heads. Your choice.
Look, guys, let's talk about this.
Oh, Ryan's face.
Got quiet all of a sudden.
The loader bots have been getting smarter and smarter.
I like to think we all have.
They must really have to go.
That is not good.
These cost so much.
Thank you kindly.
Wait. Loaderbot! Go get the car!
Stop! Thieves!
That's so cool.
Interesting.
No.
Ha ha ha!
should you do with Bond?
What the hell should I know? Your freaking bot tossed us both out. Now kindly stand still and die.
Hey,
that's all I wanted to know.
Go to the curiosity.
Could have avoided all of this.
Ow! Get your ass gone! Okay. Loader bot, put the car down.
Sure thing.
Please do something!
Weapon subsystem requires your attention.
All right, we'll have to improvise.
Time to get funky.
Just tell it to run!
Self-destruct option available.
Parting with such sweet sorrow.
Loaderbot lives.
I will name my firstborn Loaderbot. Oh, you know, probably not.
I can't believe we're alive. I mean, I never want to see somebody's brains come out of their nose. Not ever again. That was the single scariest experience of my entire life. Which should probably be over by now. But it's not. For some reason. But for those guys, a lot of those guys...
Oh, come on. It was a little fun, right? You cannot honestly stand there and tell me that it didn't feel kind of great to kick all those guys' asses.
Okay, yeah, it was a little awesome. But I'm sure it was as traumatic as it was fun. We're probably going to need some therapy in the future. You know that, right?
We'll be able to afford it. All right, let's just find this guy, August. Buy the key. Get the hell out of here.
There's gotta be some way to save, right? Let's see. Well, I'm gonna end this episode here regardless, so thank you all for watching. This was part one of episode one. We're gonna do this like Half-Life. That's how I'm gonna name them. Goodbye, everyone!